wish us luck, people. I hear you birds squawking. We're gonna do our first YouTube live test run. Hopefully it doesn't suck. It's freaking working, yeah, I can't believe it. Unreal. I can't believe it works. What up, Timber? What's up, Stephanie? Oh yeah, I don't have to type. Can you guys hear me? Volume check. Mic check. Mic check. Check. Okay, great singer. Then you definitely heard me when I didn't know it was on. Okay. That sucks. Christina, right on. Woodrick, what's up? Travis Baker, what up, fool? Camilo from Colombia. Hello, thanks for the love. Muchas gracias, señorita. I hope you're well. ¿Cómo está? ¿Qué onda? What's up? What's happening? This is so cool. I can't believe this crap works. You guys, one of the co-founders of GEGGHEAD is my partner on GEGGHEAD. His name's John Lee Brody. Big shout out to him for being the tech wizard and knowing how to do all this stuff, because I do not. I'm going to write him real quick and tell him how great he is. I'm just going to say you rule. We don't want to let him know just how great he is, because then, you know. All right. Let me tweet this out. Let me tweet it out, people. Yeah. Fight night. Alright, and we have to now type in the channel. That's youtube.com/GEGGHEAD. Bam. Alright. Thine arses hath been tweeted. That's Shakespeare for the people have been tweeted at. All right, you guys. Let's see here. What do we got? What do we got here? Good morning, Sean Juarez. Woodrick, I feel like we would be best friends, Freddie. I sing everything too. Oh, no. Dude, I do the exact same thing, Woodrick. Guilty as charged. So... this is an old school game. I muted the music because I don't steal music. I pay for music. This is an amazing game. It's called Fight Night Champion. It's really old school. Here's Fight Night Champion. You can see it in the top left side right there. It's an old school Xbox 360 game. But the single player on this, like the story mode, is so much fun. They actually make you care about the main character. And you care about him early on. They throw you right to the wolves, kind of like Sea of Thieves. They're like, yo, there you go. You're in the ocean, except now you're in a boxing ring and getting a crap beat out of you. I will, since this is working, eventually show the story mode. But I want to do some character creation with you guys so we can create our very first boxer and see what we can do with him. All right. So we're going to make this guy... that would be kind of Donnie Yen right there. A little Asian. Yeah, I think maybe we're going to do another Cowboy Donnie Yen. If you guys aren't familiar with my Grand Theft Auto character, it's Cowboy Donnie Yen. He's Donnie Yen, but he's a cowboy. And I think we're going to take that theme into Fight Night. Just got to find the best looking Asian dude on the market. That sounds weird. Excuse me. That guy's good looking. I think we're going to go with that guy. this guy looks a little more like Ryan Phillippe Asian, like he's more inward. So the ladies will be like, let it out. Let me be the one to get your feelings out. And he's like, yeah, all right. But he's not gonna. That guy. I think we're gonna go with this guy. All right. First name. All right. We're gonna. You guys already know the name. It's gonna be. We'll change it up a little. It's gonna be Donald instead of Donnie. Donald Yen. Not last Yen, but this Yen. Bam. And the nickname, there's gotta be the nickname Cowboy in here already, so this should work out perfect. Come on, come on, come on. Here we go, here we go. Chico, that's my main character. He's a three-time middleweight champion. He only has one belt right now, but he's carried all three at the same time. No, two of the three at the same time. And he took a bad loss going for the third one, but that was a while ago. I can't believe they don't have Cowboy as a nickname. All right. Could be Dynamite Donald. Dynamite Donald's going to be the leader in the clubhouse right now. He's not going to have a Mexican name because he's going to be our Japanese dude. Even though I know Donnie Yen is Chinese. Ghost Dog. The Grandmaster? That's very fitting for Donnie Yen. Hands of Stone. That would be total thievery. Huracan. Iceman International. Iron Boy? Nah. Iron Donnie Yen? Nah. No, no. I think it's gonna be. Nina would be funny. Oh, it's gotta be the Cowboy. Come on. Come on. The Cobra, the next one, Oh, you're killing me. The Dragon might work. We're going to go with the Dragon. We're going with the Dragon. It's got to be done. All right, where can we make this dude from? I would love it if Tokyo was an option. Oh, yes. Ring entrance. Can we do none? I hope I muted everything. We'll do China as the music, even though we can't play it. Ring walk, confident. Ring, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes and yes, please. Yeah, we want bursts. Who doesn't want bursts? I haven't created a guy in a long time. All right, weight class, weight class. What should we do here? Weight class, weight class. No, this is not Knockout Kings, bro. This is, now you got me thinking this is Knockout Kings. This is Fight Night, old school Fight Night from, oh, what's up, Face? From Xbox, but it's backwards compatible on the Xbox One, so I loaded it onto this. I haven't played it in forever. Essence of Scythe, of Sith, however you say it, that answer goes for you too. That goes for you too. All right, we are going to do, Donnie Yen is not a heavyweight. We're going to go lightweight, I think. Woo! Body type. Let's see, how jacked are we? That, he's looking pretty jacked. That's more Cowboy Donnie Yen-ish. We're going to go with that. Height. We could have a tall lightweight. That would be kind of cool. Make Donnie taller than normal. Man, that's 5'10", 126. That's like Paul Williams long and lanky. Rest in peace, Paul Williams. The fighter. We're going to go up to 130. Give him a sick reach. We're going to go 73. He's looking pretty white. Why is the left pec super buff and the right pec's like Kofi Kingston? Sorry, Kofi. What is that, man? No, he's not going to be bald, man. My guy's going to look good. That does not look good. Got the loaf. Man, you need to have some good hair, bro. Oh, Theo Von in the house. Whoa, that's a lot of hair, bro. That's a lot of hair. Whoa, Bieber. Bieber. Nah. No. No Jerry curl. Wait, I want to know what it looks like. That's pretty money, man. Long top curls. How do you rotate this? That's not that bad, man. He's got some good hair. That's some good hair. I wish it was a little shorter on the sides. That's terrible. All right, let's go long top curls. Black, of course. Sideburns, nah, 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 nah. Facial hair. A thin mustache would be nice. That's, I'd like it a little thinner on the lip. You know what I'm saying? Not thicker. Oh, come on. No, no goatees. Whoa, that's 90s. John B. John B. in the house singing some R&B for y'all. No. Man, I think that... Oh, that's actually not too bad. That kind of looks like him from that movie where he's dressed in the white suit. And he's also like a secret superhero back in like... England ruled China, I think back... What was that one called? Anyway, we're going to go with that. Eyebrow. Oh, yeah, let's thin those bad boys out. My, oh, come on. That's a little too well kept, boy. That's a little too well kept. Those look like mine. I'm like, eh. Self-hate. I'm all about that self-hate, baby. Yeah, I like that black hair. No, no, he's not going to. This guy's going to be hairless for sure. Tattoos. No face tattoos. But we could dress up the back with like a sick... What is that? Woo! Boy, that ain't looking too bad. Definitely gonna go with that. What is it? That's like a giant wave and a dragon coming out the bottom or something. That's fresh. Let's do a tat over the heart. You know your boxer's got to have a sweet tat over the heart, right? Need something dragon-y, though. That's... Oh, wait, what's this? A little samurai mask? Oh, there's the samurai mask. Bam! That looks whack. I like that dragon. We're going with the dragon, or whatever that is. Mythical beast. And I don't think we need to do the arms... No, I like him there. I like him there. Gloves. We're going to get sponsorships along the way, so I'm not too worried about that. Let's give him the Bruce Lee color combo, though. Oh, and I can put cowboy on the front. What? What, what? What, 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 what? Cowboy Donnie-Yen. He's back. He's back, Cowboy Donnie-Yen. He's a cowboy and he's Donnie-Yen. Alright. Show up, though. Where is it? I'm gonna go Everlast. Old school. With the fancy trunks. Bam. Text color. There's the cowboy. We're gonna go text color black. I like that. Base color, black. Waistband, yellow. They call me Mellow Yellow. That's pretty yellow. And the stripe, we need to be mellow yellow as well. That's gonna be hard to match. But all right, we're gonna do our best. Close-ish. Foul protector will leave the way it is. Dude, is this guy starting to look like a gangster or what? What's up, people? A-Rod, what up? What's up, Chrissy? Visco? What'd I miss? Badger-tastic. Badger, I take it you're not liking my tattoo selections. Is this worth buying to play with you sometime? Phantasmic Ears, if you want to, I think it'll cost you like $20. So if you got $20 laying around, then it's definitely worth a buy just for the story mode alone. But the whole character creation and having your own career and managing your fighter and training your fighter, it's a lot of fun and you can kind of play the game forever. I mean, I had this on the original Xbox when it first came out back in... I'm still playing it. I just had to buy it again. But it's already paid itself off. I'm telling you, the story mode is fan-freaking-tastic. All right. This guy's looking great. Oh, the Kofi burn? That's my boy, man. I've known Kofi for 14 years, probably. So he's going to have to take that heat. All right, robes. Not that robe. Oh, do we come out gangster? I think we might come out gangster. Let's see what the robes look like. We're going Everlast for sure. Not a lot of options here. Let's see what it looks like. No. You can unlock the Tyson Towel, and I think this guy's going to be a Tyson Towel, dude. All right, deal with that. Oh, mouth guard. Black and yellow, black and yellow. Wrong one. Black and Bruce Lee. Game of Death. Here we go. Man, that color wheel is killing me. All right. Now, we are going to be an orthodox fighter. However, you can switch stances to southpaw just by pushing left on the D-pad and then back again, obviously, to go back. Careful, because if you push right on the D-pad, and I'll never forget this, you will headbutt. And if you do that enough times on accident, you get DQ'd and you could lose a fight that you were owning. I'm sure I'll do that because I still remember it. So we're going to be an orthodox, and I know the style that I like. Is it counterpuncher? I think counterpuncher is how I go. Inside fighter, outside fighter. Or was it conventional? Oh man, I don't even remember. Okay, the defense I know is Philly Shell. I like that defense. I just don't remember. Man, that does not look like how I fought. Oh, man, this is a tough call, you guys. You're stuck with this. You know what I'm saying? It couldn't have been a counterpuncher. It couldn't have been. Maybe if I change the style. Okay, yeah. Okay. Not old school. Probably not balanced. Not upright. Not textbook. Not hyper. What's that? Cocky? No. Although, if we want to... Okay, hold on. I'm thinking about me. I got to think about what Cowboy Donnie Yen would want. He would be fast. Speed might be the way to go. Ooh, that looks kind of fresh. Or slit... Nah, that's not how he fights. Not crazy. Okay, we're going to speed. All right, my man. Punched. Oh, and punch style was already there, kind of naturally. Okay. 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 All right. All right. We can adjust any of these. Great. Counter puncher. Combinations for sure. We're gonna go a little more in the middle here. Inside fighter. I don't mind a few inside punches. Blocks punches or moves head. Let's do a little bit of both. You know what I'm saying? Because when you block a punch, you still take some damage. Ain't no need for that. Plotter or mover. We'll be going in the middle there. And we're a clean fighter, man. We're a clean fighter. Hooks are nice. I'm fine with that. Jab freak. I love that. I love that. The left uppercut is such, if you're an orthodox fighter, such a deadly shot, y'all. So we're going to do a lot more of those than most people. Move this up too. I love uppercuts. Hooks are just kind of are what they are. I've never been as good with those as far as timing punches. You guys, I think this fool is ready. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting to the amateur tournament, Donald the Dragon. Yeah. All right, don't erase anything. Apply changes and continue to legacy mode. Whew, here we go. Welcome to Boxer Growth. Here you will assign XP to your boxer's skills and review your current athleticism. Your legacy mode boxer has started off with a few skills, but you'll need to earn XP by fighting to grow them further while maintaining your athleticism by training. Once you've completed the upcoming amateur tournament, you may return to Boxer Growth by selecting it from My Boxer within Legacy Central. That's just a fancy way of your growth tree, like a role-playing game. Alright, here we go. We got 750 XP. We definitely want to have a fantastical jab. And let's get our... Ooh, we can't do combos yet? Yes, we can. Let's get our combos up. And then we're gonna... You can't, like, back exit out, so you just press start. And then apply changes and continue. That makes our boxer a little better. We don't need to import opponents. We're going to let it create them. Sometimes you run into old school legends on here, and you'll fight like Jake LaMotta. Or what are we? Welterweight? Lightweight? I don't remember what we are. We'll create a new one. And this is CD. Whoa. Oh, yeah. Okay, we can still do that. CDY. Cowboy Donnie Yen. All right. And I'll show you guys my fighter, too, if you want to see him. His name is Freddie Jr. His nickname's Chico. He's 28 years old. I think he's like 26-1 with one draw, 24 knockouts. He's a three-time champion. He's held two of the three belts at once. He's kind of a stud. All right, you guys. First fight's coming up. I'm a little scared. All right, Visco. Kayfabe. What up, Kayfabe? Aaron McGowan. Let's do this. Roscoe Wolf. Hey, man. I just played a little Sea of Thieves. It was kind of my last stream on Twitch. And I'm going to do it a lot more. And I'll do some invites as well where I stream with people I don't know. Just homies that I met on Xbox and Twitter. And we'll do some full Galleon ones on Sea of Thieves as well. So stay tuned for those. But today is a test, so I brought out an old school game, and we're going to kick some butt. But in order to kick proper butt, we need coffee. I hope you invite me then. Right on, Chris. I see you on Twitter a lot, man. We'll get in there.
Remember, guys. Obey my commands at all times.
Oh, my guy's fighting for
Let's
the
have
U.S.
a good,
I
clean
guess.
Fight. Touch him up.
He's from Tokyo. My boxer from Tokyo. Woo. I didn't like those. Boom. Oh, he likes the uppercut. Oh, he likes that. Ooh, damn. It's tagging, bro. Chill, bro. This is an old game, man, and these graphics hold up pretty good. Oh, give me that. You put a good jab out there, man. It messes everybody up. Tag him. Got him. Oh, come on. That headgear's killing me. That's round one in the books. Cowboy Donnie Yen looking good with a jab and a lead left uppercut that he landed repeatedly to the chin of Linares.
You're not winning this fight, okay?
I didn't see Linares' first name.
He's beating you. I need you to throw more than one punch out.
You can skip this at any time. Here we go, Cowboy Donnie Yen, baby. Back on the jab. Oh, I just missed that. Get out of me, scrub! Be holding. You tired, boy? You tired, boy? Oh, he tagged me.
Keep your hands up.
He's like, I got jabs too, bro. That's all right. Now, this is amateur scoring. That's why you're seeing those numbers on the bottom.
You all right?
128-70.
You got to let it go.
We're going to school this fool.
You got to let it go.
Going to put it on him, baby. Cowboy down again. Wait till you see the sidekick. Nah, son. You missed, baby. Ooh, big body shot from Cowboy down again. Oh, with the right hand. Oh, he's hurt. Now, if we hold down the left bumper when we punch, it's a power shot. It takes a lot of stamina, but you can really put a hurting on him. Stung me right there, bad. Ooh, two big uppercuts. It's that overhand right that keeps tagging me, bro. It's all right, we won that round, and we won that fight. Let's go. Get that first win, baby. Get that first win. Take care, Visco. Peace. Yeah, Roscoe, it's hard to get knockouts with the headgears on. Once you get into your career and you have any kind of power, you're putting guys out. Like my other guy has like a 92% knockout ratio. And they're usually like between the third and fifth round knockouts. Although I've had a couple fights go the distance. All right, this guy got taxed. Against E. Joppy. Grandson of William Joppy. Not really, I don't know. Here we go, guys. Let's go. Cowboy Donnie. Timber. Boom. Timber Vlogs, your name is very appropriate for a boxing stream. When I knock these fools out,
okay, guys,
it's going to be Timber.
We went over the rules in the dressing room. Let's touch gloves.
All right. It's the great-grandson of William Joppy. That with you. You better run. Get off me. Nobody grabs Cowboy Donnie yet. I wonder if they can't do commentary because I'm live streaming, or if in the amateurs there's no commentary. Usually you get Joe Tessitore and Teddy Atlas giving their opinions of the fight. Oh, tag! Oh, you're lucky, boy. You're lucky, boy. Cowboy Donnie Yen looking strong through one.
Just keep doing what you're doing.
No one puts Donnie Yen in the corner. No one.
Don't fight his fight. Jab and move.
He's gonna fight my fight because I'm Cowboy freaking Donnie Yen. Everybody fights my fight. He's the best there is. Giant body shot. Take that. You're my heavy bag. My personal heavy bag. Even though you just tagged me like 3 times. Get off, Donnie Yen. You clinched by pressing both the left and right bumper at the same time. I think that's how you get him off. I know you can push, I just don't remember how to push. Come on. Fall down for Donnie. Fall down for Cowboy Donnie Yen. Get off, Cowboy Donnie Yen. Well, I think we got a push there. I think we did.
This is all we got. One more round.
Come on. Round three coming up. Fight night.
All night long. This is your fight. You are in control, right? No
Maverick, what's happening?
This is your
fight night champion.
Yeah.
Frost Kaiser, you are correct. And Cowboy Donnie Yen is an ongoing theme for
round,
a lot of my characters.
Okay? This is it.
And,
one more round, and that's it.
This is yet
go for the
another,
head this round, okay?
What's the word I'm looking for?
You
another
need
incarnation
to capitalize on his misses, okay?
But all of them are winners. Cowboy Donnie Yen. He's a cowboy and he's Donnie Yen. Only today he's a boxer in the amateurs. Take it. Damn, son. What I gotta hit you with, bruh? Oh, he almost killed me. got it back. You got it back. Oh, he didn't like that.
Oh, you got this one.
Ooh, two nice uppercuts at feet. Get him, Cowboys. Oh, man. I went for it all with that body shot. Man, I want that knockout so bad.
Side to side.
Woo! I can't get it. Them headgears are strong. Cowboy Donnie Yen, baby. It ain't a belt. It's a title. That's right, Roscoe. Believe that. Basement Ninja, I totally agree, man. And if you're anything like me, you're going to be ducking and moving when you're trying to punch. All right, are we in the finals yet? Semifinals, I think. Versus A. Velasquez. We're going to call him Abel. It's a great name for a fighter. Abel Velasquez. You guys, I'm loving that the live stream is working. I'm loving it.
All right, gentlemen. Protect yourselves at all times.
You could totally box, Badger. Box it up. Box it up, girl. Of course, that would require motivation. Something that many of us lack. Get off me, Velasquez. You're already holding soft ass. Take that, take that, take that, take that, take that. Better back up off you, boy. What's wrong with you, boy? Sucker, sucker. Man, day guard for the liver shot. Nice, man. I don't know how I get all these uppercuts in, but I can't ever get that liver shot. Oh, I knew I was going to get tagged right there. Boy. Almost doubled him. Almost doubled him.
Don't get lazy out there, all right?
I won't.
Get lazy.
I won't get lazy. So, Velasquez, what you got, fool? Get off me, fool. Damn, this guy's having a good round. That ends now. What happened to that good round, baby? What happened to it? This is a 3-round fight. I don't need to worry about stamina. What you got, fool? What you got, fool?
Listen, I'm not gonna stand here and watch you take those shots. You understand me? Let's see some defense and more corners.
Let's go. Round three. Round three.
You need to create more counters, okay? If it's tough.
Essence of, man, I'm trying to get these body shots in. It's tough, though, dude. My man's like this. But Cowboy Johnny Yang never says die. Oh, he's fighting like Miguel Cotto in there. The body attack is real. Oh, I just got turned. So that's a combination of A and X, the uppercut, and the right uppercut is Y and B. Or you can use the right thumbstick. But I don't remember all the motions for it, so I'm not using the thumbstick. Man, I hit this fool with some uppercuts and just couldn't rattle him at all. You still lost, scrub. Cheeks, cheeks. Oh, sorry, that's not his name. I mean, Cowboy Dunia. Oh, with no armpit hair either. Dang, what's up, personal groomer? All manicured and whatnot, looking all crisp. All right, here come the finals. Donnie Yen versus Freddie Ramirez. It's not a good fighter's name. Franklin Ramirez. Franklin. Better name, right? Whoa, why does that guy look like Colby Covington? That's kind of random. Way narrowed out. His manscaped game is strong.
Remember, guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, here we are in the amateur finals. The two greatest amateur boxers in the world. Square off, touch gloves, and we're ready for war.
The opening bell. Round number
Cowboy Donnie Yen early with the uppercuts. He's wasting no time on the bigger man.
Expected to be a thriller. Ramirez is a fighter who takes such pride in knowing no man has ever conquered him. How can that play a role tonight?
Oh, this guy's like
the most important way is
the old school veteran. Oh, and I hear the commentator.
Get into those dark areas, those tough corridors. You just remember,
you gotta earn
the
commentator.
You don't want to lose it. You don't want to give it up. You hold on to that.
When you're facing a guy who you know utilizes the hook well, what do you want to be conscious of?
Well, you want to be conscious of range and distance. He has to get close to use that hook. So you try not to let him get close. Once they get into those parameters, you want to be aware that that punch is coming from the side.
The dragon's doing well here with that.
Oh, they called him the dragon. They just called him the dragon. That gets him hyped. Hype city, y'all. Hype city.
Not what he was looking for.
Woo! Three punch right combo. Gave him that three piece. That Masvidal diet.
So
put him on that game bread fighter diet, baby. Bam! Three piece. Here comes your soda. Bam! Soda! Soda!
And you can see that label.
I might have to make a Jorge Masvidal fighter
this
on this dude.
Punch
serve out three pieces in buffets.
Really,
I love the way he says buffet.
Hits you. It makes
buffet.
You think of those stories you used
I'm
to
saying
hear
buffet
in the old days. Maybe your grandfather, maybe your father talked
Francisco,
about Rocky
that's a way better name than
guy.
Franklin.
He's former heavyweight champ of the world. He hit
show
you anywhere. He didn't care.
The
back
dragon.
Of the head, he hit you on the arms, and he start breaking you down. This guy doesn't care. He just throws.
Let's do this.
Here we go. Round two is underway. Well placed double jab.
Did you try to hit me with an uppercut? That's my punch, fool. Only the dragon throws the deadly uppercut.
That punch intended for the head.
Ooh, how you like it, boy? Ramirez like it, baby.
Is not throwing.
What achievement unlocked? I'm just doing
what would you
my
say
jab.
To him?
Well, first of all,
I'm just doing my jab.
What do you think that he's gonna make a deal with you? If you don't,
if they were slick.
Hard,
they haven't taken my
hard.
Dad's old.
No, no, it doesn't work like that, my
it's not my jab.
He's gonna get confidence now. He's gonna take advantage of this.
Combo lands to the head.
Man, this guy's D is sick.
Committing up top now, he goes there again.
Oh, that hurt.
Comes right back at him with a left hand.
Hook up, jab. Hook up, jab.
He got hit.
Man, I'm
right
getting
there,
stung up right there.
Gave one. Solid effort.
I don't know if I won that round.
Predictions in boxing is often a dangerous task, but I'll make one right here that seems pretty obvious to me as we come to the end of that round.
Oh, man.
This fight is going to be a brutal display as long as it lasts.
It's kind of like going and watching that home run contest. Nobody's trying to hit singles or doubles. You know they're all going for the fences.
Man, this guy just, it's all D, all the time.
Staying away from those headshots with his
get off me, bum. Man, his jab is sick.
Ramirez's defense, is it ever good? Look at how easy he's able to block those punches.
Hey, I got good defense too, Tessitore. Don't be biased, bro.
Good, clean shot, returning fire. Well done by the Dragon. Ramirez's combination.
How you like that?
Punching is working.
How you like
well
that,
here.
Ramirez?
The Dragon strategy has been to control things on the outside. And the jab fits perfectly into it.
Yeah, what it's done is it's set up his defense. He's kept his opponent defensive, kept him off balance, off stride. And it's also set up his power.
Oh, I'll
shot
take a five-punch combo all day.
He took a shot, but he gives one of his own, a left-hand score.
Stamina's starting to take a little hit.
Side, side, move your head, side, side. Come on,
all right, we won that round. We won that round.
Digging deep. Got it in you, champ.
2-1, 2-1. Come on. Come on, Cowboy. Ah, knock my coffee
they
over.
Put forth a
oh, no.
Throughout. Now one more meeting. The final round is here.
Nice hook. Nice hook, baby. Woo! Lead uppercut. Come on, fool. What you scared of, fool?
Nice work.
Thought you were the amateur champ.
Here's one for you now, he says. Right back with the left hand.
Where you running? Where you running? I got hooks too, baby. I got hooks too, baby.
Punches and bunches. Combination up top.
Tagged him. Tagged him. Should have stuck with that left.
Comes right back at him with a left hand.
Oh, we ain't losing this round. Hell no.
He tried to nab him up top, but was unable to connect. Oh, he took some damage, but he gave some back with the right hand. The Dragon's starting to soar at ease.
Come on, Dragon.
Opponent there. Anytime you can land a three-punch combination,
yeah, nice try, fool.
You're really hitting your groove.
Yeah, boy, yeah!
The final bell.
We won that.
This bout,
we won that. For sure we won that.
We send it up to the ring.
You know you lost. You know you lost. You know you got beat. Raise my hand. Yeah! Get out of here, bum. I'm moving on to the pros. To the pros!
A unanimous decision. Teddy, your scorecard falls in line, and everybody here in the arena knows
Donald
exactly what happened.
Yeah, this was an easy thing. One. I mean, I think that you would have had a big problem with the crowd, not to mention...
Donnie's way better. Fabian Ramirez. Advanced to tournament results. Yeah, man, we won. All right, we are officially pro. Fighter of the Tournament Award, fantastic. No KOs, that's so weak. All right, y'all. We're going to go to the message center. That's where you get all your info. Your trainer, let's get it started. If you want to be the greatest of all time, you'll have to train hard and sacrifice everything to be the best. Remember, kid, no one can do it for you. You have to do it yourself. That's just a good life lesson. Just not even in boxing, just in life. We'll go ahead and delete that meaningful message. All right. My Boxer is where you go to Boxer Growth or change the way you look and edit Boxer. We're going to go to Growth, and that's where you apply your XP right there. We have none. It should have given us some. That's not cool. We'll have to earn some in sparring through training. And we will schedule a fight. Right now we're a prospect, but a strong one. All right. Who do we want to fight here? All these guys are bums just like we are. We're 45. We'll go with 44 or 43. This guy's only got a 68 inch reach. This guy's super little, but he's got a good reach. We'll take this guy, I think. Let's see. 73, 74. We can take this fool out. Sylvester West. Yeah, I'm sure. Book it. Choosing a location for training camp is important for your boxer's development. Each camp will affect the growth of your athleticism differently and have a different set of training games to build your skills. So all this is, you guys, is as you get money, you can train in Philly, Detroit, Puerto Rico, England, Mexico, or Big Bear. And they all do different stuff for you. And you can open spar or do other exercises to train, to add levels to everything, and then rest your fighter. Usually you'll have 4 weeks. And then with the next one, or basically you have room to do two things. You have room to train once in an open spar. That'll be, I think, half your stamina. And then room for one athletic, which will add a big stat to just one. That'll take you down to like 30% stamina. Then you have to rest to get back to 100. Otherwise, your stamina will be affected in the fight. We don't have enough money to do any of these, so we're going to home gym it. We're going to book our training camp right now. Now that you're scheduled your first fight, it's time to train. And I can tell you about all this. It's easy. Just go to train. Skills training is where you add to everything. Athletic training is where you add to one specific thing. We're going to start with skills training. We have 4 weeks to our fight. You can see it's right here. So we will skill it up. We're going to do an open spar. And the better you perform in sparring, the more you'll get to each stat. The worse you perform, obviously, the less you get to each stat. But it's better to do these because it hits everything. You just have to find the game that you're best at and then focus in on that. Don't worry about getting good at all of them. Otherwise, you're going to really sort of nerf yourself, so to speak. So just focus on what you're good at. If you're good at timing, you can do speed bag stuff. If you're not, stay away from that. Damn, Donnie. Looking hella swole. Looking like a heavyweight.
Let's go. Work it out. Work
tell him to work too. Don't just tell him. It's my sparring partner. Don't run. Fight, bruh.
Get about being tired.
Oh, miss.
Hey, you got some of that too. Let's go.
We want to get up near 40,000 if we can, but. Like I said, it's been a while.
Nice, nice.
Better punches you do, combos obviously get more points. You get hit, you lose points. You get knocked down, you lose a lot of points.
Come on, pick it up. Looking good.
Oh, he could have tagged me. I missed that hook so bad.
Push it, kid.
Come on. Come on, FP. Get to 40, baby. We need those champion numbers. Champion numbers.
That shit down.
Come on, get to 40. Ooh. Yeah! That's what we're looking for. You see on the right side, prospect, contender, champion. That adds the max. Anything over 40, there's no bonus for 50. You can see my high right there, 71. But no matter what, that's going to be the cap, your top one there. So that's your goal. Unless you're trying to outdo me and embarrass me and post it on my timeline on Twitter and be like, what up, scrub? Don't do that. Now, our current stamina is at half. So you can't just train every week or you're going to go into the fight with nothing. So you can either do another training session and rest, or what I like to do is just rest now. Every rest session you do will be 80% recovery. That gets us to full. Then for this one, you can focus in on a specific skill that you want to improve on. So for me, it would probably be like conditioning and endurance because I throw a lot of punches. Or I could just go do another boxing session and try to raise everything, which is what I'm going to try to do. Let's see who my partner is today. Tony, I got your back, bro.
Let's see how you feel.
John Lee Brody plays NHL like a maniac, and I will ask him to start streaming if that's something you did, Chris. Maybe we'll get a lot of Canadian viewers. Back up! Back up! Won't you ever throw those weak shots at me? Hit him with the 1-2. Bang, bang, bang. Woo, got him. Ooh, tagged him. That was a power shot too, by the way. I don't know if you saw the stamina bar drop a little bit. That's why he's covering up big time right now. Scrub. You ain't got nothing for me? Boom.
Kid. You want to win in that ring? Work hard.
Yeah. Put it on him. Put it on him. Put it on him, cowboy. Come on now. Oh, I thought I was good. Oh, I did. Should have hurt him way more. Oh, he almost stung me back. Look how mad he got. We'll take it, we'll take it.
That's good.
So that raises all our stats again, which to me is way better than focusing in on certain things. But you'll kind of see your stats will vary from time to time, and every once in a while you're going to have to focus in. Or you might take a fight on short notice where you only have one training session available. You might suck at sparring, so you really have to focus on those. So however you play. All right, you guys. We are going to rest our fighter. And it's time for our first professional fight. We're going to go to our message center. These are fight challenges, the things they want you to accomplish. But to me, winning is the accomplishment. Just win, baby. Here we go. Let's do this. Cowboy Donnie Yen. Cowboy Donnie Yen. Pro debut right now. Here we go.
Okay, guys,
Not a lot of people here for the Dragon's first fight against this tomato can. Look at this guy. Look at this guy. This guy looks like a history teacher. Damn, a history teacher with a mean right uppercut. Come on, don't be soft. Get off me, bum. What you got? What you got?
Hey, you gotta see that coming. Now let's go.
Come on, break him down. Break him down. Shots already, bum.
Get after him.
Come on, you're getting him. You're getting him. Where you running? Where you running? Where you going, boy? Where you going? You better run. You better run. Cowboy, done it yet. What's wrong with you? Don't you ever grab Cowboy. Oh, stung him. Four piece. Let's go, Cowboy. Let's go, Cowboy. Great hairline, by the way,
like
Cowboy Donnie Yen. Great hairline. Whoever selected that must have had great hair in the 90s. Ugh. Man, why are you always grabbing on me, dude? Why you love me so much? Why are you all in love with me? Eat some. Finally, man. You gotta start throwing punches. His corner goes, you need to block more. Telemarketers shouldn't be allowed to have computers make the call. I feel like they should have to sit there while the phone rings. That would make it more fair. Like hunting with a bow and arrow instead of a rifle. You know what I'm saying? Ooh, he threw the giant shot. But so can I. Come on, baby.
You need to capitalize on his mistakes. I want to see that.
Hug it out, hug it out. He is
a
hugger.
Pay for his mistakes.
All right, here we go. Round three, round three. The pro debut of Cowboy Donnie. Come on, man.
Come on, kid.
Oh, nice. Oh my goodness. Hang on one sec, guys. This is getting ridiculous. if I turn it off, they can't call. We had to go on that do not call list, but they say it takes a month before it actually works, so we'll see. Ah, Frick. Getting too uppercut hungry. This guy's not gonna open up for that punch. He's just gonna run for his life and try to counterpunch you to death. There we go.
Oh, you got this one.
There we go. Come on, cowboy. Come on, cowboy. Nice body shot. Nice uppercuts.
Side to side, move your head.
This guy likes to counter that jab, doesn't he?
Stay away from those. Come on.
My bad. Come on, cowboy, get it. Missing way too much. Nice, cowboy. Nice. Man. Man, come fight me, bro. Just run this whole time, man. Damn. This ain't no Irishman, dude. Irishmen wouldn't run like that. Irish fighters come forward. Wayne McCullough would be disgusted at this man. Oh, I just blocked that. Come on. Some more power, man, especially with those uppercuts. Man, you run a lot. Come on, cowboy. Come on. There we go. Tag this fool. That's gotta be three rounds to nothing. Or four rounds to nothing, whatever we're at. Oh, I almost cursed. Fight, dude. Man, I wish you would fight. Oh, how you like those body shots, baby? Oh, where you at? You're running, man. What's wrong, son? Stay in his pocket, son. Why are you scared of the pocket, baby? Why are you scared of the pocket, baby? Oh, that should have been a bigger shot. He was bad. What's up, baby?
Relax.
What's up, move baby? You scared of the pocket? Oh, I thought I was gonna nail him with that. This guy is so scared, man. You don't got what it takes. You don't got, oh, I thought that was the bell. My bad, my bad. All right, that's five for me. That's five for me, but we're getting tired. Don't get sloppy, kid. Come on. You got fantastic hair and no sideburns. Let's do this. You don't have any body hair anywhere on you. You're perfectly shorn. You got half a chest like Kofi Kingston, the other half like Sly Stallone. You're the best there ever was.
Side. Move away from the rope.
You got nothing for me. You got nothing for me, West. You got nothing for me, you bum. You hump. Try to grab me, scrub. Try to grab me, boy. My eyes getting tired.
You're not patient.
Look at that jab. Look at that beautiful jab. Touch that face up. Touch that face up. Grabbing on Donnie Yen. Trying to get some shady uppercut off the break. I don't think so, baby. I don't think so, fool. A tired Donnie Yen is better than West at full strength. Look at you. Look at you. Come on, cowboy. That was life. Oh! That's my new combo on this guy. Jab, jab, right uppercut.
That's it!
Alright! Finish strong, baby! You didn't win a round. Any judge that gave him a round is corrupt, paid for. Cowboy's looking way swole, man. He looked that swole in character creation. You gave the last round to that fool? Corruption. Corruption in the game. Complete and total corruption. What's up, y'all? Donnie can take punches, man. Pete McDonald, what up? Badger-tastic, that's right. He's too slick, man. Like a newborn baby boy. Except for this and this. So, and this. And all that great stuff. Okay, so, my boxer. Now you guys can actually see this. Now we've got some XP to play with, right? So we definitely, you can auto-assign and it kind of knows where to put it, which is good. Or you can kind of fool with it yourself, which is what I like to do. You definitely want to have a powerful jab that people respect. We want that uppercut way stronger. And we'll auto-assign sometimes too. Make sure the chin is strong. Make sure the heart's strong, the blocking's strong, all that good stuff. No messages. And then we'll schedule our next fight. And I'm guessing when we get beyond prospect that Tony Atlas and Joe Tessitore come back and start announcing our fights. I hope you guys dug the live stream. I can't believe it worked. I got a special announcement this Friday right around 1 o'clock p.m. Pacific time, we're doing our first live tabletop game on this channel. This was kind of a test for that. We're shooting it on the new stage. I'm hosting it. It's Catan. Our cast is Amy Louise Pemberton, Claire Grant, Kid Rio, and Taylor Gray from Geg Wars and Star Wars Rebels. They're all really, really skilled players, way better than me. I'm going to host it. They're going to play it. It's going to be live on this channel right here. So please tell your friends. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. I'll post about it on Twitter and stuff like that too. It'll be not a test run, but our first run with board games in the new stage with all the new lights, computers, sound, all that crap. I hope you guys dig it. I appreciate you guys tuning in. And on behalf of everyone at GEGGHEAD, I'm Freddie Prinze Jr. wishing all of you a very good evening and good game. Peace.